Greg, the Prime Minister is saying that Barbuda is barely habitable now, somewhere near 90% destruction, according to him. What did you see flying with him over there today?
Yeah, that's exactly what I agree with the number there. It was absolutely shocking and emotional for all of us on the helicopter because we just couldn't believe what we were seeing. Just buildings gone or just a pile of rubble, rooftops gone. Water everywhere. It's a flat island, and the water is not running away. It's just water everywhere, so people are wading through water to walk down the road. It's just unbelievable. It really is.
I know you've been flying for some 18 years. I mean, have you ever seen anything like this?
No, I haven't. When I first got to Antigua, I've seen some damage from Hurricane Jose, and, you know, it was kind of shocking, but... nothing like this. This was unbelievable. And the Prime Minister said the same thing. It's just he's never seen anything like it. It's just unbelievable.
It looks from the pictures like you were able to fly pretty low. Were you seeing people on the ground there?
Yeah, we were able to see people on the ground. I wanted to make sure the Prime Minister got a good view of what had happened. And, yeah, we could see people walking around. We saw one guy up on his roof already trying to repair it, I guess, so it doesn't leak tonight or next couple of days, because we got another one coming.
And are there rescue or recovery assets in the area that you could see?
What we had hoped we'd see something from the French, from the French Islands, but they were all busy taking care of their own problems in French St. Martin. So, but there will be some response. We've got a couple of international organizations that will probably start to get into action. And tomorrow we're involved. Going to be moving water and supplies. The Coast Guard boat will probably be able to get onto the seas now that they've gone down and start moving things over. We're going to be very busy tomorrow.
And what's the condition of the airport, the runway?
The runway, it's interesting. There's some big divots that have been left by a container, you know, a 40-foot steel shipping container, and it did a tumble across the ground through the airport grounds and over the runway and the apron. And the container is nowhere to be found. We don't know where the container went, but the markings on the pavement are obvious that it was a big steel container. You can tell one of the markings is really obvious. And
it just
where it went, we don't know.
Is the runway usable?
A skilled pilot might be able to, and if he knows that there is some small divots in the runway that he might be able to maneuver around them, like in a small twin-engine Islander, for example, that we fly down in these islands.
So obviously, for relief efforts, a working runway is important.
Yeah, I think it wouldn't take much to fix it. If they came over with a bucket of hot in a boat with a hot pitch, they could have it go up and going fairly quickly. The holes aren't very big. There's nothing there right now, you know.
It's just incredible. Greg Scott, I appreciate talking to you. Thank you.
Not a problem. Take care.
Well, more on the storm next, including the view of it from 45,000 feet. What a NOAA hurricane-chasing flight director told me about the data coming from inside the massive weather system late today and why he says it's growing stronger. Later, politics. Did the man who had someone ghostwrite a book called The Art of the Deal for him get royally rolled by the Democrats? How some say President Trump gave away the store in a debt ceiling talks today and the fallout from it tonight.
Endless Shrimp is back at Red Lobster, and we went all out to bring you even more incredible shrimp and new flavors. Like new Nashville hot shrimp drizzled with sweet amber honey, and new grilled Mediterranean shrimp finished with a savory